What is up, boys? Welcome back. It's me, Random Internet Person, here. Back for the first time in a while, I guess. I made myself mistakenly available every day at work, thinking that, of course, there'd be some days where the weather was too inclement to fly. And that, of course, turned out to not be true here for the last 2 months, basically. So I've worked almost every day since the beginning of April. It's kind of marginal here today, so got a little bit of free time in the F-16, which I have not spent a lot of time in recently, and the goal today is some wild weasel action. We're going to go to Syria and try to find some stuff to blow up there. We're going to have to get some missiles to shoot at us. And I'll walk you a little bit more through what the plan is once I get this thing started up and get the alignment started inside. Let's go. Also had some comments on a video recently about someone, you know, complaining that I was doing the procedures wrong and stuff. If you're coming here for tutorials, GTFO, boys. I have no idea what I'm doing, which you'll probably see here shortly. Just because you fly airplanes in real life doesn't mean that you know anything about them in the simulator. Also, currently we're in Incirlik, probably butchering that, Incirlik, Turkey. And we're going to fly over to Syria. We've got two HARM 88 Charlies and two of these murderous Rube Goldberg devices, the CBU-97s. So we're going to try to get some SAMs to shoot at us so we can find them. And then we're going to blow them up. The alignment process in here, unless I'm doing something wrong, I know that it'll say ready pretty early, even if it doesn't give you the most precise alignment, but in order for it to be, I guess, as accurate as possible, you have to wait quite a while for it to align. I was told that, right, so if you go through now in your UFC, it's already in the lat long, so we hit enter there, go down to longitude, and altitude, enter, but I don't think that doesn't seem to do anything. It doesn't seem to speed up this process. Now we just wait. So it should show us the INS is ready here in a couple seconds, but like I said, when it starts flashing, that means you're kind of the most accurate alignment, and that takes quite a while. So right now, you could just yeet it, but to me, once you get airborne, it starts to have a whole bunch of errors and stuff that make navigating kind of difficult. I don't know if that's a bug or if that's the way that it is in the actual airplane. So like I said, we got two 88 Charlies. The goal is to get the search radars to lock onto us. We're going to launch the HARMs at those. We need them to shoot at us because that's the only way that I'm going to be able to find the actual SAM site. And once I have visual, hopefully the search radar is going to get taken out by the 88 Charlies, and then I'll be able to get in with the CBU-97s and drop those on top of them. We'll see how that works out. It might end up being a short video if I get clapped as soon as I make it into Syria. We'll find out shortly. One of the cool things about this airplane, besides obviously the aesthetics, it's pretty badass. Check out the deflection on the flight stick. So this is all the way aft, right there. All the way forward. You can see that with the controls. That is a tiny little bit of movement. So you're flying this thing with your fingertips, basically. Elbow a little elbow holder over here. And as far as, you know, Eagle Dynamics airplanes go, obviously pretty feature incomplete at the moment, but I trust that they're going to kind of sort that out as they move forward, given the state of the F-18 now. It looks awesome. It sounds good, but I don't know how to do most of the stuff. And as far as I understand, there's not a lot of stuff that's really fully implemented as of yet anyway. So probably not missing out on too much. Base here. See ya. So we have a tanker on station in case we need it, but I have no confidence in my ability to actually do air-to-air refueling in this, considering where the refueling probe is, or the hull behind you. May just eat it here. I think that it gets to 8.0. I'm not mistaken here on the fine alignment for the INS, which is 8.0 and then down to 10 on the right side. So we still got a ways to go on this. Almost there. Let's go. Come on, buddy. Also, as far as I know, there's no stored heading or anything like you can do in the Hornet that speed this process up, but I am not an expert on the F-16 at the moment. Should be ready here in a second. Should start flashing at us. There we go. Final line, switch this to nav. And return, let's go. Nose wheel steering's on, parking brake's off. boys, place your bets on how long we are going to survive today. Also, say what you want about the module. I mean, I guess in its current state of completion, but man, the canopy on this, the view out of the cockpit is pretty much unparalleled. That is awesome. I cannot imagine what it'd be like to fly one of these things in real life. That is neat. Alrighty, let's go master arm on and air to ground mode. Select the AGM 88s. There we go, power on. SMS weapon, here we go. So, as far as I understand, there's a couple of different modes that you can use with the HARMS. This is the way that I've been doing it. So, you select which table for the threat. So, table one, we've got SA-10s, Big Bird, Clamshell, 11s, SDs. Table 2, Table 3, so depending on what you're seeing on your RWR is what table that you would select over here on the actual display for the weapon. And then you basically, you're going to press the, there we go, you kind of use the slave just like you would with the radar over here. You can lock it up. A lot of these things are still placeholders, though. Like I said, there's a lot of feature incompleteness, so to speak. I don't know what I'm looking for. Go waypoint 3. We'll aim for 25,000. Should we just keep going until we get on this other layer of clouds up here? So our flight plan doesn't actually go to the spot where the surface-to-air sites are. It's gonna get us in the ballpark, and we're gonna have to use the RWR, I guess, to find. There we go. All right, we got a search radar going. So there we go. S. If we point in that general direction, let me take autopilot off. And we can see it now on the display for the harm. And it's locked. And like I said, I have no idea where these guys are, so I have to have them fire at me so I can see that smoke trail to be able to visually acquire them and actually use the CBU-97s. Okay, now we get a 6. Unlock this guy. Go for the 6 first. And the 6, there we go. It's on the same table. Alright, 6 is locked. Like I said, maybe a short video here. Gisan Young. Oreman. And a 6 is definitely the more immediate threat. Jinsa Oreman. Kibun yotte. Again, I have no idea how to use the symbology up here to determine how far away this thing actually is, so I'm basically kind of just waiting for it to start lighting us up. The RWR will start chirping at us. And I would assume probably for a 6, I'd be inside the launch parameters for the harm, particularly at this altitude at 30,000 feet. We will find out shortly. Preemptively start swinging this around a notch here. That is not a launch warning yet. Like I said, I do need him to launch on us. That's a launch. I think I did him. I think I see a column of smoke over there. So let's get this back. Weapons page. How do I do this? No idea. Stores management, maybe? SMS. Here we go. Inventory. Here we go. Now I gotta go find that smoke column. I definitely hit him. Oh, okay. Got tracers here. We're in the ballpark, boys.
Altitude.
Oh, there he is right there. We are going to jump up here and dive bomb him.
Altitude.
Okay, it's going off now. Hell yes. We got a few kills down there. Definitely the AAA is still up, but I'd say that that one is... Oh, hello. Wow.
Altitude.
Probably out of commission on that one. Climb back up and look for the second guy. There's a search radar, so we are on table 3. It should still be good to go. Upside it down. There it is. Looks like a 2. So it should be pretty useless if I take out the search radar here in a second. The 2 is awake, so we gotta be getting close. shoot at us. Sort of preemptively notching here. Doing a too good of a job notching? Shoot, buddy. Freaking me out, man. And now the two's off. Did I hit anything? Kill, I did. I guess now we're looking for a smoke trail or something. Altitude. Get low and see if we can see anything popping up above the horizon. Hello. What have we here? No AAA on this one. It's positive. Oh, just came back on. I want to stay close on this one.
Pull up. Pull up. Altitude. 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 Altitude.
Bombs away.
Altitude.
Came off the wing. I don't know if that had the altitude to actually. Oh, there it goes. It did work. Yes. Do one more pass here, make sure we killed everything. Gun selected just in case.
Altitude. Altitude.
See one more missile down there. Well, we're here. Let's hit him with a gun.
Altitude. Altitude.
Yeah, let's go waypoint one and see if I can land this thing. Done, master arm off. We're at 3.8. I think we started with 8.9. I think we're good. Autopilot is on, and we're on steering. I think steering select, so it's automatically going to fly us towards our waypoint. 105 miles. Down there, I believe. Yep. here we go. Switch between calibrated airspeed, true airspeed. So let's see, calibrated is 360 knots, true airspeed, 583, ground speed, zero, okay. Keep it calibrated. There's a way here on the, whatever this little thing is called, to also do this on the list. For nav, no, INS. Here we go, ground speed, 583. So basically the same as our true airspeed. Miles. Pitch hold there and just allow this to descend us down. We got 50 miles. Should be off the coast. Almost back at Turkey. This thing is kind of a trick to land. The wheels, the main landing gear pretty far forward on the fuselage, which means that if you're kind of below a certain airspeed, your angle of attack is too high, you can tail strike pretty easy. So kind of hard to flare. I guess it's easy to land, but hard to do smoothly, so we'll see how this goes. Plus, it has tiny little wings, so your landing speed, your approach speed is generally going to be like 140 or something like that. Uses a lot of runway. Go ahead and take the autopilot off here. 20 miles. And we took off runway 23, so we're going to come in, I guess, what's our heading right now, 297. Should basically be on an extended left base for 23 now. Starting slowing down. There it is. There we go, on speed at 148 knots, which is crazy. hold the nose up for aerodynamic braking. What is up, dude? How you doing? Put that down. I have not, no. I'm kind of spoiled with the payware planes, the freeware mods and stuff. Downloaded a couple of them, like the A4 and just the interior textures. I'm like, eh. Doesn't do it for me. Well, I've heard positive things about the newer A4 patch. I don't know. Like I said, I'm not too enthusiastic about the mods. It is, but I wasn't too, I guess, impressed with the interior textures that I saw from the screenshots, promotional stuff. Yeah, sims in general are pretty niche, and then, you know, having combat sims is its own niche. How you been, man? What's up with you? How's work going? Heck yeah, dude. Hit me up tonight. I was just talking earlier about how I've been working for like pretty much the last 2 months straight, and the weather is marginal today, so it's the last 2 days are the only days that I've had off in the last 2 months. Got burned out, man. What is BSOD research? Blue screen of death, what does that mean? What are you researching exactly? And how's your sim pit coming? You made any progress on that? How's that going? Sounds complicated. Oh, D-bags in here? What a creeper. Never turned on my radio that whole time. Whoops. Kind of. I mean, the only thing that I still don't know how to do any stuff with the targeting pod. I haven't learned the Mavericks yet, which are kind of my favorite weapon. Oh, you hate them. They're kind of my favorite air-to-ground weapon to use. Because I haven't had much time to play with it since I got it. So I just did a little mission with the Harms, and I CCIP'd some CVU-97s. I'm alive. Took out two SAM sites by myself, so that's positive. I'm not even sure, to be honest, how much is actually implemented in the aircraft at the moment anyway. That's cool. You can hear the turbine blades. Still hoping, fingers crossed this week, that the Hind comes out. I know there's planning for a patch either this week or the next, so hopefully it comes with those. It is, but I was saying earlier, I mean, given how much work ED's done with the Hornet and how feature complete that is right now, I mean, it's not particularly my favorite aircraft to fly, but it's definitely one of the best in DCS in terms of fidelity and how much is actually involved there. So I have a high level of confidence that they're going to have the same sort of approach with the F-16. It's just going to take some time. How'd you get the Hind for free? What the heck is this sorcery? Oh, I didn't know that's the one. I remember you told me that you won a free module. I didn't know it was the Hind. That's awesome. Whose stream was it? Gotcha. That probably brings the viewers in right there. If I had the money, I'd do module giveaways too. Next time I get a Twitch payout, maybe we'll give one away. Anyway, dudes, I'm gonna get out of here. I gotta go check the weather. I'm supposed to have a flight at 4. I don't think it's gonna happen because it's still pretty marginal and there's some convective sigmets in the area, so I doubt it. Have you been flying DCS recently? Remember you said about a week ago you're teaching some other people to fly the Hornet. If you are, if you're going to be in the evening tonight maybe, hit me up. I'll be around, presumably. Oh, Grau's back? I didn't know he... Damn, what's that guy been up to? Tell him I said hey. That's a name I haven't seen in a while. Yeah, no, I don't remember the last time. I think the last time I saw him streaming was honestly still in Korea. Busy with real life. Guess kind of been the same recently here. Anyway, I'm out of here, guys. Melon, good talking to you, buddy. If you're going to play DCS sometime this week, hit me up. Even if I am working, I'm usually home by 7 or something. 7 here, so 6 p.m. your time. Yeah, if you see him again, tell him I said hey. See ya. Peace.